Hi folks, Glyn here, back with another video for you, and this time I want to show you how you can increase muscle using Photoshop. Alright, so I've just had a bit of a sort out recently since getting back from Photoshop World, and I came across this picture on my hard drive. Now this is a picture of a guy, it's a composite. The guy was a rugby player, obviously. And this isn't really the kind of work that I do nowadays, but when I saw it, it kind of reminded me of a technique that I used on him, which may be useful for you now. So we'll kind of go through it. It might be something that you never use, but you know, it's a bit of fun. It's experimenting and playing around, just seeing what we can do. You might be able to find something else that you could use it on. So what I'm going to show you then, let's just dive over to Photoshop, is how this guy here, Sam, we can actually make his back look just a little bit more muscular. Because you can see here, he's got one of those, it's kind of like a shrink wrap top on there, really compressing him down. And although he did have a muscular back, it wasn't really showing through. So here's what we can do to give him some muscle. Now, it just so happens over on my hard drive, I've got a picture of this guy here. This is my friend of mine called Nigel St. Louis. This is from a photo shoot quite some time ago now, and nowadays Nigel is considerably bigger. But this here, being the straightforward shot of his back, will work out ideal for what we need. So here's what we're going to do. We're going to get my lasso tool, and I'm just going to make a very, very rough selection of his back, like so. Just get the move tool, and then we'll drag it over. Hold it over the tab so we can bring it into this picture of Sam. You can see obviously it needs resizing, so let's just zoom out a bit and we'll go Command or Control T to get the free transform, and we'll just resize it quite a bit so far. And to help us kind of position it where we need it, let's just lower the opacity down just a touch. So when I zoom in now, hopefully you'll be able to see it. You can just about see the outline of his white top, and we can see where Nigel's back is now. So I'm just going to kind of reposition it just a touch. So around about there, the base of his neck, this little bit down here, this bit on this part is where Nigel's back is. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to right click within here now and go to warp, and then I'm just going to kind of like manipulate it around just a little bit. Doesn't need to be exact, but we just want to kind of line it up to roughly where it would be. And you can see that Nigel's back was photographed square on, so his back was perfectly flat towards the camera. Sam's got a bit of an angle to him, so we can kind of mimic that just a little bit by clicking in, when we're using warp, clicking in one of these right or left-hand side squares and just pushing it across. And you can see there, it gives it a little bit of a twist so that it does look like it's not square on like it originally was. So we can see we've got the trapezius area here. Let's just bring those up just a little bit. Something like that. And that should be fine. I'm going to go through it really, really quickly here. That kind of positioned quite nicely. We'll press enter or return to commit that in. Let Photoshop do its thing. Let's just bring up the opacity now to 100% so we can see here what we have of Nigel. Now obviously Nigel's back is up on his own layer just here. So what I need to do, although Nigel here isn't really tensing and it does look like his muscles are quite very defined there, we need to give him a little bit more oomph for them to work and definitely stand out on the white top that Sam's wearing. So all I'm going to do is go to the filter menu and we'll choose camera raw. And when we're in the camera raw filter, what we'll do is, let's just zoom in just a touch by clicking down there. All I'm going to do first of all is really whack up the old clarity. You can see straight away that's going to start to bring out the detail there for us. So we'll go something like that. This lower portion of Nigel's back is just a little bit too dark. There wasn't that much light on it. So let's just get an adjustment brush, bring up the exposure just a touch, bring up the shadows a bit. Let's just bring the clarity down a little bit there as well. And we'll just kind of paint that in, because all we need to see is the actual, just the shape of the muscle area just there. Let's just brighten this part up here and this part here. But we can see where we've got the upper part of the back is the main part we're after. And this central bit here, where the two sides, the two lats of his back there are kind of joining in right down the middle. So that's good. I think we actually could use a new brush here, a new adjustment brush. Just clicking on the new, and let's just double click on the exposure slider to bring that to zero. Double click on the shadows, and we'll just pump up the clarity just a little bit, and I'll paint over his trapezius here, because this is the main area that I want to stand out on Sam's back, and maybe down that middle bit just there. Okay, so that's looking good. I think we'll also, let's just come out of there by clicking on the hand tool. So we've now got the basic tab here. And I'm going to bring down the saturation. But I'm also going to go to the details tab here. We've got noise reduction. And I'm going to bring that up quite a bit just to smooth out. Because as we pumped up the clarity, it brought out a lot of detail and texture within his skin, which we don't really want. Let's just pump that up just a little bit. And we'll just play around with the luminance detail here, see what else we can get. Luminance contrast. In fact, let's go back to the basic tab there and just increase the contrast just a bit so we can see they're really starting to make those muscles stand out. Something like that. And we'll click OK to send it back over into Photoshop. It's a 16-bit file, so it's going to take a little bit of processing. But then we come to that there, which is kind of cool. Then what we're going to do is just going to get a blend mode. We're going to change the blend mode now, actually. We're going to go from normal, and we'll probably try overlay. And that's going to really darken it down. Sorry, it's not going to darken it down. It's going to get rid of the gray, predominantly get rid of that gray. And already we can start to see the actual shape here of the muscles showing up on the back. There's a little bit of tidying up we need to do. But we can see also we've got these areas going around outside of Sam. That's when we actually did the lasso around Nigel's back. So all I'm gonna do, hold down my Alt or Option key, click on the layer mask icon to hide it, then get a normal soft-edged round brush. Let's just make sure there's no crazy settings in here that are gonna make it behave differently than I want. And we're going to paint in a white foreground colour. Then all I'm going to do is just come in and start to paint on Sam's back to bring the muscles in where I want them to be. So certainly down that middle bit just there. A little bit on his traps, nice bit of shadowing actually there, quite liking that. And something like that. Now this lower part of his back here may be just a little bit too obvious. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to reduce that down. I'm going to change to a black foreground colour. And we'll paint it, yeah, around about 50%. Nice big brush so we get the feathered edge of it and just kind of brush it gently over that bit so it kind of blends it away so it's a bit more natural kind of fade into his back there. All right, so looking quite good. These areas either side of his lats, we don't really need those too much. So I'm gonna get my brush again with black. I'm just gonna put a few strokes just to reduce that and reduce that bit there because it's mainly the middle and the upper part of his traps that we wanna work on. Let's just bring it down, just paint gently in there just to take it away, just a touch. And what I think I'll also do is go to the filter menu. While I'm actually clicking over on the in the layers panel now, if we zoom in, I'm actually on the actual back here. I'm not working on the layer mask now. I'm clicking on the back thumbnail itself. So let's just go back out. You go filter, blur, and Gaussian blur, just to smooth it out just a touch. Doesn't need to be too contrasting too hard, because bear in mind the muscles are actually underneath this rugby top that he's wearing, so they wouldn't be that defined. But we do want them to show out a little bit. So it's almost like we're using this picture of Nigel here, playing around with it by making it black and white, and then using the high pass. It's almost like we're doing a bit of dodging and burning on it. So let's just bring that up. Around about 5 is pretty good. And we can click OK, and let's just zoom out just a touch. And we could come in, maybe just reduce that, because we've got the back on its own layer. Let's take that down to maybe, I don't know, 70%, something like that. But very quickly, again, it's just a bit of an experimentation here. We can turn that on and off, and we can see now how we can start to bring out muscles that were actually there on Sam, but we can use somebody else's to really start to bring them through on the T-shirt there. So I don't know where you're gonna use that. It's certainly good if you're doing physique stuff. You can see from the original picture, if you dive back over into Lightroom, shift and tab to hide everything else. We can see here that I did that on Sam myself. It kind of worked for that picture, but I'll be interested to see, or hear rather, where you use it. If you might be a physique photographer that you want to enhance somebody's muscles, you may find some completely different way to use it. But just let me know. It's a bit of fun playing around. And that's pretty much it. So there you go, there's the video. Just to let you know, if you want to get the files that I've used in this, the one of Nigel and the one of Sam, all you need to do is just subscribe to the newsletter over my website, glynjewish.com, and then every week when the newsletter comes out, it should be every Monday, there'll be a link in there so that you can go to the website and download the tutorial videos files so that you can actually follow along as well, as opposed to just sitting there and watching. So that's the newsletter, and also make sure you subscribe to this YouTube channel. It's great just to see those numbers grow. It knows there's a lot of support out there and people are liking the content. But for now, I'll see you next time.